Welcome back. In this lecture, we will see how UDFs play an important role in PIG. UDF stands for user-defined function. A PIG UDF is a function that is accessible to PIG but written in a language that isn't PIG Latin. PIG allows users to register UDFs for use within a PIG Latin script. In previous lecture, we learned that PIG has limited set of functions in comparison to what Oracle or MySQL provides. So we can write analytic functions to process data. UDFs provide capability to do custom data processing in PIG. UDFs are easy to use and code. PIG UDFs can be executed in multiple languages like Java, Python, JavaScript, etc. With PIG UDFs, we can process anything like image feature extraction, geocomputation, data cleaning, natural language processing, and much more. PIG allows users to combine existing operators with their code via UDFs. Piggy Bank is nothing but the collection of user-contributed UDFs that is released along with PIG. Piggy Bank UDFs are need to be registered manually in the PIG jar when used in PIG scripts. There are three types of UDF in PIG: Eval UDF, Aggregation UDF, and Filter UDF. Eval UDF. Eval UDF are used in for each type statements in PIG Latin. Look at the example here. We are defining a relation in the first step. And in the second step, we are doing string processing using our UDF to generate names in lowercase. This is one of the example of eval UDF. Aggregation UDF. These type of UDFs are applied on group data. This is similar to function we use during a group by statement in SQL like sum, count, etc. So, aggregate functions are used to combine multiple pieces of information. In this example, we are calculating number of sales by product. Look at the relations here. Filter UDF. A filter UDF is used to filter data based on some condition. They return Boolean values. So, in this example, we are filtering abusive comments from given set of data. Look at the relations here. Whenever you submit PIG queries, PIG converts them into set of MapReduce jobs. A separate instance of UDF will be constructed and run in each map and reduce task. This is where your UDF will run in Hadoop. I hope till now you have enjoyed learning Hadoop and its component. Next lecture is gonna be really super exciting as you are going to have a lot of hands-on experience. See you in the next lecture.